Golden Knights forward Jonathan Marchessault in Saturday's post-game scrums didn't mince any words about the importance of Game 2, "We are going to see what kind of team we are," Marchessault said, following the Jets' 4-2 win. "It's a must-win next game." After a night's sleep, Vegas coach Gerard Gallant wasn't so sure about that. "Must-win," Gallant repeated, Sunday. "There's no must-win games until you're down 3-0. Or 3-1 or 3-2, players don't usually use the term, either. It can put undue pressure on them, as long as he responds with it," Gallant said. "Plays his best game. But if you're asking me if Mondays is a must-win game, no, it isn't, not technically, of course. But going down, 2-0, in a best-of-7 forces a team to win 4 of the next 5. Which is exactly the predicament the Jets want to put Vegas in. Huge, is how Winnipeg's Andrew Kopp described Game 2. "We don't really want to be heading to Vegas, 1-1. We had a good game, but it doesn't really mean anything if we come out and lay an egg Monday. We've got to be sharp, because we know they're going to make a push, especially early in Game 2. Kopp wasn't surprised to hear Marchessault's dire assessment in the other room. "It's a long series, but it's a quick series, too," he said. "You find yourself in a 2-0 hole, they'd be going back home, they've been great at home, so that'll give them some confidence, but you don't want to put yourself behind the 8-ball. We're trying to stay ahead of it," like two brick walls. Vegas winger Ryan Reaves was the first player in a long time to get the better of the Jets' Dustin Byfuglien in a collision in Game 1. As big as Reaves is, 225 pounds, Byfuglien still outweighs him by some 35 pounds. "That was two brick walls hitting each other," is how Reaves described it. "It's not often you can run him over. When you get a chance, you could take a little bit of a shot, maybe get him off his game. He doesn't take those shots very often. He's a big boy who's tough to handle." Reaves was a physical force for the Knights in Game 1, and it was no coincidence one of his other targets was Jets captain Blake Wheeler. "I know who it is I'm hitting," he said. "I'm going to go after anybody that I can. As long as I stay out of the box. Doesn't matter who it is. It's an added bonus, it's the captain, all about speed overall." Kopp didn't think Saturday's game was as physical as the Jets' series with Nashville. "It was just a totally different dynamic," he said. "The Nashville series was really physical, especially down low. And Saturday's game was more about speed and skill. A little bit contrasting styles." Jets coach Paul Maurice says that change in styles takes some time to adjust to. He points to defenseman Jacob Trouba's interference penalty in the first period as an example. "That was happening in every corner all series long, against Nashville," Maurice said. "Now it doesn't happen quite as much, so it becomes more noticeable to the referees. So we have to make an adjustment." Kopp expects the pace to pick up even more against Vegas. "This series is going to be based off of a lot of speed," he said. "We know how fast they can be and how fast they play. They probably play faster than their actual skating speed is. We know how important it is to take that away from them. Covering for Byfuglien's sparkling postseason play is impossible to ignore. Sometimes, he still surprises teammates with where he ends up on the ice, all the time," defenseman Jacob Trouba said. "But that's just who he is and what makes him as good as he is. He'll be in spots that you kind of scratch your head and then he'll make something happen and do something crazy. There's a special appreciation you have for it, and his teammates. You have to cover for him." Still puzzled after Game 1, Gallant wondered aloud why nobody asked him about the Jets' third goal, awarded after a goalie interference call was overturned upon review. Sunday, Gallant was asked if he got an explanation. "Explanation from who?" he said. The referees don't give you an explanation. It goes to Toronto. They make the decision. I wasn't happy about it. I disagreed with the decision Saturday. I disagreed with it today. But we move on. Nothing we could do about it. Joel Armia was ruled to have bumped goalie Marc-Andre Fleury, but only after the puck was on its way into the net. The last word. I've got an older brother, Mike, and a younger brother, Jay, and we want to say Happy Mother's Day. My older brother's message was thanks for having us. And all the hockey moms in Canada, Happy Mother's Day, is how Maurice began his media scrum, Sunday.